Gano'n nyo tinitake? Kumbaga nagiging hard on yourself ba kayo pagdating sa pag-arte, pagdating sa inilalabas nyo sa camera?
Siyempre. Opo. I mean, I try to not think about it kasi sinasabi ko, ako ko na isipin, just enjoy. Kasi ano experience namin sa Forevermore po? When we were shooting sa Baguio, wala kaming signal, we didn't have any cell phones. Shoot lang kami ng shoot, and then a couple months after, sinabi nila na, hey, ang lakas ng Forevermore. We didn't even know about. So siguro nakita nila yung closest time, we didn't have cell phones. So yung buong cast, kwentuhan lang. So siguro the bonding na nangyari without thinking about anything, we were far from ABS, from the people, just in the mountains. It made us forget about everything, so we didn't have to try. We just say it came out so naturally, siguro. And I think that's when people are, ano yung chemistry niyo? What's your secret? Feeling ko the secret to no chemistry is having no chemistry at all, not even trying to have any chemistry. It just comes naturally. So yun ang na-realize ko, so parang try not to think about it. Just enjoy it. I mean, it's hard not to, you know, to be hard on yourself. Pero minsan ganun eh. The more you think about it, halatang you're trying hard. Just believe in yourself, enjoy, and people will see that.
Parang nag-worry ka rin ba dyan sa sasabihin ng mga tao, ng mga mananood?
Yes! Oh, syempre, minsan sa success ng Forevermore, of course, you're gonna expect na yung Dulce Amore, karoon din. I mean, you can't, you know, please everybody, but you try your best. So, sinasabi ko lang, basta pag mag-enjoy tayo, syempre, the people will see it, and sila rin mag-enjoy. So, pag nawala yung essence ng enjoyment, wala rin.
Yeah. Aisa?
Ako po, kapaligtad niya, I tend to overthink. So, ako po yung talagang hard on myself. Like,
sabi ko sa kanya, don't think about it. Okay.
Kasi I get scared that, like, one day, like, hindi ako magiging kasing, how do you say this? Like, as good as my last show. So, I want every show, there's something different, and to be able to show that I am capable of giving something else, offering something else to the audience. And I just want that the management can also see more potential in me and that I can do other things. Parang ganun po.
Enrique, ano yung realization sa pagiging mahirap, sa pagiging raketero?
Ano po, sorry?
Yung realization sa character mo, pagiging mahirap, tapos pagiging raketero, diba, ang dami mo raket.
How easy you have it sometimes, you know? How much, like, when I was shooting doon sa construction, nakita ko yung mga ibang construction, tinuturo mag-welding, you know, mag-ano, sinabi ko, grabe, I mean, you just go around, see all these establishments, you take it for granted, you don't know how hard these people work for that. And to be in it and be in their, you know, do what they do, you have no reason to complain of what you're doing compared to what they're doing. So it just opens, you know, your mind. And I just, you know, iba, I don't know. It shows you things that you really didn't know. It opens up your mind, and it's a humbling experience when you're there.
Naisa, feel na feel mo yung pagiging prinsesa.
Well, actually, hindi po talaga prinsesa yung role ko. It's just a girl who is living a glamorous life. Ako po, hindi po. I never wished kasi to be a princess or to be anything more than what I actually am in real life. So, ako mas gusto mo yung simple lang. Yung ganun. Pero it's nice to portray the role of being a princess para maiba naman. But for me, in real life, I'd rather be ordinary.
Sabi ni Enrique, queen daw. Sabi ni Enrique, queen daw. Ano yata? Queen of his heart yata. Yun.
May push talaga. And of course, here's a question from the queen of our Tita Ethel. Hi, Tita Ethel.